you've probably heard the phrase, ideas are a dime a dozen. Once you have those ideas, how do you get the feedback on them? How do you hone them? How do you advance them? How do I make it so big that it could affect everybody?
We are now part of the fourth industrial revolution.
This is the heyday of computer science. And in particular, it's the heyday of big data.
A lot of things are coming together. The ability to communicate broadly. The ability to do commerce without a lot of banking infrastructure.
Healthcare, insurance, communications. Any industry has a technology component.
We're going to make as much progress in the next 10 or 20 years as we did in the last 100.
Part of this change will be determined by research done in places like Jacobs Technion Cornell and Cornell Tech.
All I need to do is build the infrastructure, and you put it into the hands of these bright students at Cornell Tech, they'll think of things we never thought of before, and our lives will be dramatically different.
The whole concept of building out a tech campus on Roosevelt Island came when Mayor Bloomberg wanted to start something that would be another Silicon Valley.
Companies get started where people go to school. We want it to happen right here.
I received a letter from Mayor Bloomberg inviting the Technion to participate in international competition.
It was very exciting when the chance came for Cornell and the Technion to be together to do this project in New York.
It seemed that the Technion was a perfect partner for us. Israel, after all, is known as the startup nation.
It will position us to be a leader in the industries that will define the 21st century economy.
Chuck Feeney believes in giving while living, in seeing the results of your philanthropy and good work in your lifetime. Cornell Tech is an excellent example of the power of Chuck's giving philosophy.
We won the competition, and the rest is history.
Even the physical space, the campus of Cornell Tech, is designed to foster collaboration. The Bloomberg Center, which is the main academic building in the first phase, is an open plan building, and it will have students of all these different backgrounds and faculty working together in this open space. And that's extraordinary in academia.
Sometimes we do talk about Cornell Tech a little bit in the verbiage of being a startup itself.
We built the program based on what was needed in the city of New York.
Well, New York has always been a city that looks to the future, and that's exactly what Cornell Tech does. The subjects being studied here, whether it's science, technology, entrepreneurship, they're all about creating a better world.
It's a remarkable opportunity for our students, and I also think it's a remarkable opportunity for the companies.
Every business leader today wants to spend time with us learning more about what's the digital age mean for their business, their industry, how it's changing.
This model that Dan has created will attract into New York talent from around the world that will stay here in New York and drive the next rounds of innovation.
You know, if you want to build products for the world, it helps to be where the world is so you can find out what works and what doesn't.
When you leave out most of the women and most of the minorities, you're going to have solutions that are impoverished relative to what you could get if everybody was included.
The tech industry does not look like America, and they have to look more like America.
Cornell Tech is being set up to cover some broad areas to bring people together from different backgrounds.
People from different disciplines creating new ideas.
Lawyers, social scientists, engineers.
You pull people in from all over the world, you get their thinking on these problems, and you come up with unique perspectives.
If I had gone into any other grad school program as an engineer in the computer science program, I would maybe be lucky to bump into someone into some other engineering.
That process of bringing together deep expertise in various different aspects of a problem is one fundamental aspect of taking ideas and making them bigger.
Universities usually are very slow, but here we have a university that can adapt very easily.
A new technical university in Manhattan, in New York City. It's beautiful.
As I walk through this campus, I have an incredible feeling of excitement and accomplishment. We've had unparalleled institutional support from a whole range of actors, governments, the university, companies. We're shepherding top research and educational programs for the digital age, the computing and information sciences, digital aspects of engineering, parts of business and law and policy, academic programs that have been evolving and iterating rapidly and that we continue and expect to continue to iterate. Cornell Tech isn't just an idea, it's a reality, and already the beginnings of an overwhelming new success.
This campus on Roosevelt Island will become a leader
we're going to solve some of the world's problems.
The thing about Cornell Tech that's most important to remember is you ain't seen nothing yet.